Hi there, and welcome back to 365 Data Science. In today's lesson, we'll answer the fundamental question, what is data architecture? We'll cover the core concepts of data architecture, the three main components, storage, processing, and access, why data architecture matters in modern business, the roles of data architects and engineers, and real-world examples of data architecture in action. Let's dive in. While the term data architecture might sound daunting and complex, I'm here to ensure that by the end of this lesson, you have a clear picture of what exactly data architecture means. Let's start with a simple question. Have you ever wondered how companies like Amazon, Netflix, or Google handle so much data and still deliver seamless experiences? Well, the secret lies in something called data architecture that can also be seen as the backbone of every modern data-driven organization. Today, we're going to dive into what data architecture is, why it's such a big deal, and how it's transforming businesses around the world. But before we dive into our city planning analogy, a quick word about today's lesson. If you're finding this introduction to data architecture helpful, you'll love our comprehensive courses at 365datascience.com. We offer in-depth training in data architecture, data engineering, and building data pipelines from scratch. Our step-by-step approach helps you master these crucial skills at your own pace with hands-on projects and real-world examples. Now let's return to our exploration of data architecture fundamentals. If you were planning a city, what would be the key components of building the first design? A city plan would consist of buildings where people live and work, shops to ensure necessary supplies for the people, and roads and bridges to connect all these pieces. This is exactly how a data architecture blueprint works. It ensures there is a place to store data, and there are pipelines or roads to flow data from place A to place B, either within an organization or outside. Data architecture is the framework that ensures data gets where it needs to go efficiently and securely. This could be to power a dashboard, train an AI model, or to even process your favorite food delivery order. At its core, data architecture includes three main components. The first, storage. This is where the data lives. Common examples of storage systems are databases and data warehouse. The second, processing. This layer is responsible for identifying how data needs to be cleaned and transformed into something useful. And lastly, access, that take care of how people and systems get to that data. We'll go into the details of each of these components in upcoming lessons. But before that, let's try and understand why data architecture is important. Organizations rely on data architecture to make faster, smarter decisions, saving them time. Scale operations as they grow to ensure optimal use of resources. And most importantly, keep data secure and compliant with regulations. As the amount of data we collect is increasing every second, it is ever more crucial to have right boundaries and controls set up so data does not end up in the wrong hands. Good data architecture isn't just about storing data, it's about making it usable and valuable. That's why companies are investing heavily in it. Without good data architecture, managing data can feel like untangling a giant mess of wires. But with the right design, you can turn chaos into clarity. So, who's behind all this? How do these ideas of building and maintaining large-scale data systems become reality? That's where data architects and data engineers come in. A data architect designs the blueprint. Their job is to figure out how the data will be ingested, where it will be stored, how it will flow to different parts of the system as needed, and how it will be secured. Think of a data architect as an urban planner for the city who lays out the high-level blueprint and design. Once the blueprints are ready, the data engineers come in. Data engineers are the builders. They take the architect's design and bring it to life, creating pipelines to ingest and flow data, managing databases to store the data, and making sure all the processes are complying with the organization's security requirements. Together, they build systems that can handle billions of rows of data daily. Lastly, before we close, let's talk impact. How has good data architecture impacted organizations worldwide? Have you ever logged into Netflix and seen the section called Recommendations for You? Not so surprisingly, Netflix creates unique personal recommendations for all of its approximately 282 million users in real time. They're able to do this because they have a robust data architecture set up to capture user data and build meaningful insights from it. An organization like Amazon relies on its strong data architecture to track inventory, manage supply chains, and offer one-click shopping to millions of concurrent users around the world. And a bank like JP Morgan uses well-designed architectures to detect fraudulent credit card transactions in real time. These aren't just limited to technology giants. Any business that's serious about growth and innovation needs strong data architecture to stay competitive. So that's a quick introduction to data architecture, a system or framework that turns raw data into strategic advantage. Now let's recap the key points we've covered in this lesson. Data architecture consists of three main components: storage, processing, and access. It's crucial for making faster decisions, scaling operations, and maintaining data security. Data architects design the blueprint, while data engineers implement the solutions. Real-world examples include Netflix's recommendation system and Amazon's inventory management. Every business, regardless of size, needs robust data architecture to remain competitive. Thanks for watching this lesson on data architecture. If you found this information helpful, check out our comprehensive courses at 365datascience.com for more in-depth content on data architecture, engineering, and analytics. Until next time, keep learning!